Hey cool worlds, it's David. Exciting news from the world of astronomy this last couple of weeks as astronomers think that they have discovered the first example of an asteroid which has come from an alien star system, the first interstellar asteroid. The asteroid was discovered by the Pan-STARRS 1 telescope in Hawaii, which routinely discovers asteroids all the time. But on the 19th of October, the asteroid that they saw was kind of weird because it was moving so much faster than anything they'd ever seen before. The asteroid is in the center of this image and the telescope is tracking along with it. So all of the other stars in the background are kind of blurred out, smeared out in this photo. It turns out that this asteroid is moving 60,000 miles per hour too fast for the sun to hold onto it. So this asteroid will leave the solar system and travel on to wherever it goes next. Because this object is so special, the discoverers felt like it deserved to have a special name as well. And so they proposed a name which has now been accepted by the International Astronomical Union. And it is spelt like this over here. You pronounce it Oumuamua. That's Oumuamua. And that's appropriately a Hawaiian name after the Hawaiian telescope which discovered it, which means a messenger from afar arriving first. Now the asteroid is moving so fast that the time it takes for it to enter the solar system, as let's say defined by the orbit of Neptune, to leaving it is just 10 years. That's really, really short time for something to cross that vast a distance. Oumuamua has already had its closest approach to the sun, which we call perihelion. It would have happened about the 9th of September. At that time, it would have been traveling about 200,000 miles per hour and would have been about a quarter of the separation between the Earth and the sun. So that's actually interior to Mercury's orbit. It's really difficult to backtrace exactly where this interstellar interloper would have come from, but it has been suggested that it may have come from the Carina and Columba associations in the southern sky, which is about 200 light years away. So indeed, this was the first ever discovery, but Pan-STARRS 1 is a relatively new telescope, and it was only really looking at a small patch of the sky when it discovered this asteroid. So maybe we can use this information to extrapolate what the rate of these objects might be. So astronomers have done that calculation, and the numbers suggest that there are of order of 10,000 of these interstellar interlopers in the solar system right now. So given that Oumuamua is taking 10 years to enter and exit the solar system, then if I have 10,000 in the solar system right now, that means that every year there is, on average, 1,000 of these things entering the solar system and exiting the solar system. That means that there are, on average, 3 of these interstellar asteroids which have entered the solar system today, and 3 which have exited. And this corresponds to potentially trillions of these things over the history of the solar system. I think this discovery certainly forces us to re-examine the idea of panspermia. That's the hypothesis that life could hitch a ride on, say, an interstellar asteroid, travel between the stars, and potentially seed life across the galaxy that way. Now, since the discovery by Pan-STARRS 1, there has, of course, been a lot of activity by astronomers trying to observe this object as much as they can before it gets too far away from us to see it anymore. Now, we're still hearing new results from this effort coming in almost every day at the moment, but what we can tell right now is, for example, it doesn't have a coma like a comet, so it is certainly an asteroid and not a comet. Second, it likely has a dark surface consistent with a rocky or metallic composition. And most recently, we've been able to observe that the brightness of this asteroid modulates periodically every 7.3 hours, which we interpret to be the rotation period of this object. But what's weird about that observation is that the amplitude of this modulation corresponds to a factor of 10 change in the brightness of this object. Now that implies that the aspect ratio, the shape of this object, is 10 to 1. In other words, it is a very thin, long cigar, 10 times longer than it is in height. For comparison, there is nothing in the solar system we have ever observed which looks like this. So it's kind of weird that the first ever interstellar asteroid looks nothing like any other asteroid we've ever seen in the solar system. With an estimated length of 400 meters, this thing looks like a giant cigar flying through space. I think if this thing wasn't just spinning around in space every 7.3 hours, you know, you might genuinely be concerned that this was an interstellar visitor flying through the solar system. But, you know, right now we're not panicking about that just yet. But it's certainly a really interesting discovery, and I think what's exciting is the questions it opens up and the fact that we can potentially answer some of these questions by discovering more of these objects in the future. Who knows, we may even be able to send a sample mission one day and actually do essentially exogeology and, you know, measure the properties, the chemistry of materials which come from outside of the solar system. That would be incredibly exciting. So thank you so much for watching, everybody. Let me know if you have any questions about this discovery and I'll try my best to answer it down below. I wasn't involved or even in the same field as this discovery, but I just thought it was so cool. I really had to tell you guys about it on here. So thanks again for watching. If you haven't already, of course, make sure you subscribe so you can get all of our videos from the Cool Worlds channel. We have several new papers about to come out of the Cool Worlds lab, and we're going to tell you about them here soon. And stay tuned for some updates on our exomoon search as well, coming maybe after Thanksgiving. So until next time, stay thoughtful and stay curious.